Hello all, this is Thambi Medabala, Junior Scientific Officer in Exercise Physiology, Sports Authority of India. So in this lecture, I would like to discuss about the cardiovascular physiology or CVS physiology. So the outcome of my lecture would be the functional anatomy of the cardiovascular system, myocardial physiology, cardiac cycle, cardiac output control and blood pressures. First of all, let us see what is the function, what are the main functions of the CVS. CVS consisting of three major part. One is the heart, blood vessel and blood. CVS, cardiovascular system. Cardio pertaining to the heart, vascular the word meaning of blood vessels, and the blood, which is a connective tissue, is being handled by your cardiovascular system or CVS. So now it is CVS consisting of the three the units. One is the heart, blood vessel and blood. The cardiovascular system is one of the primitive system of the body. Actually, the heart is a modified blood vessel which starts its pumping or contraction during the intrauterine life, particularly from 7th week of intrauterine life. The first system in our body or our developmental stage is seen is cardiovascular system. And the general functions and the transportation, everything transports the cardiovascular system. The main aim of the cardiovascular system is to transport the blood from one place to the another place, so that it transporting the oxygen, carbon dioxide, nutrients, hormones and other things, whatever there in the blood, particularly the immune cells, WBCs, RBCs and everything being transported from one place to the another place for physiological purpose. And the regulation, the cardiovascular system regulates the body temperature, particularly the body temperature. And under protection, the cardiovascular system do involve in the blood loss, against the blood loss, that is blood loss prevention, that is known as hemostasis, not homeostasis, that is hemostasis, prevention of loss of blood from injured blood vessels, and the production of synthesis of certain hormones also involved by the cardiovascular system. And coming to the functional anatomy of heart, so we have heart is consisting of four chambers. We have two chambers just lying above. These chambers are known as the atrium. This is right side of the heart. This is left side of the heart. Now, the right side of the heart consisting of the right atrium and right ventricle, the left side of the heart consisting of the left atrium and left ventricle. Apparently, the heart consisting of four chambers, the above two chambers, atria, below two chambers or ventricles. We have two systems of circulation. In the heart, we have two systems. One is the pulmonary circulation. Second is the systemic circulation. The pulmonary circulation means the blood which is pumping from the right ventricle to the pulmonary artery or pulmonary circulation. The blood apparently goes into the pulmonary circulation, that means into the lungs, where the blood again oxygenates and come back into the left atrium. So this is known as the pulmonary circulation. And the systemic circulation begins from the left ventricle and then into the arch of aorta, thoracic aorta, abdominal aorta, and all over the body up to the head and neck, and then comes back the deoxygenated blood into the inferior and superior vena cavas and into the right atrium. This is known as the systemic circulation. So Ultimately, the cardiovascular system, CVS, consisting of two circulations. One is the pulmonary circulation, the second one is the systemic circulation. The main aim of the pulmonary circulation is to oxygenate the blood. Blood has to be oxygenated every time. The main function of the systemic circulation in order to pump the blood into the system in order to supply the oxygen, nutrients, hormones, the proteins, binding proteins, and other metabolites. And when you look at the cardiac muscles as such, the functional anatomy of the heart, so we have the heart muscles in the heart consisting of heart muscles. So these muscles known as the myocardial muscles. In our body, we have three types of muscles. One is the skeletal muscle, second is the cardiac muscle, third is smooth muscle. The skeletal muscle, the muscle which is attaching to the skeleton, and majority proportion of our body is made up of the skeletal muscle. When you look at the heart is specialized tissue, they're made up of with the specialized cells known as the cardiac muscles. So these are known as cardiac muscles. So these cardiac muscles looks like more or less the skeletal muscle, but this cardiac muscle appears like a sheet. It's kind of sheet, not like a cylindrical structure, because of presence of lot of branchings. The cardiac muscle has got a lot of branchings, so that it appears like a sheet. It modified like a sheet because the heart has to handle the blood, not skeletal muscle. Because of the blood is a fluid tissue, connective tissue. In order to handle the blood, the muscle has to modify like a sheet. Okay, and these sheets are striated muscles like a skeletal muscle, but having a lot of branches with multiple nuclei and having the lot of branches and uninucleated and intercalated discs are there, and T-tubules and Z-discs also there like a skeletal muscle. In the sense, there are invagination of the sarcolemma, the cell membrane of the cardiac muscle, into the cytosol, that is known as the T-tubule. I would be talking about the what are the T-tubules and what are those functions. So the take home message of this slide is the cardiac muscles are having the highly branched and sheets and the intercalated discs and having the gap junctions too. That means the entire muscles contracts like a one single unit, that is called syncytium. And now the functional anatomy of the heart and the walls, its walls. We have valves, for example, this is the left ventricular part of the heart, left atrium. Left ventricle, this is during the contraction of the left ventricle, when the cavity of the left ventricle will reduce, the volume of the left ventricle reduces during the contraction, and the blood is diverting into the arch of aorta or great vessel, which is supplying the blood to the systemic circulation. At the same time, during contraction of the heart, the atrioventricular valve is closed. Atrioventricular valve is closed. So aortic valves are open so that blood is moving towards the arch of aorta. And here the case is reversed during the relaxation. Heart always contract, relax, contract, relax. For example, this is an atrium, right and left atrium. This is left and right ventricle. So atria entirely contract. While atria contract, the ventricle relaxes. When ventricle contract, atria relax. So So this is how atria ventricle contract in the heart. So the no chambers, no four chambers contract at the same time, because once the atria contract, the atria has to, you know, the flow blood into the ventricle. In this time, the ventricle has to relax in order to fill the blood. While ventricle contract, atria has to relax in order to receive the blood. So you can make out these structures here. So while atria contract, so what happens? The ventricle relaxes so that the atrioventricular valve opens, the blood propels into the ventricle. Apparently the arch of aorta, the valve, aortic valve is closed. What happens during the ventricular contraction? The case is reverse. Atrioventricular valve is closed because the blood has to pump into the arch of aorta, to the systemic circulation. So atrioventricular valves prevent the backflow of the blood into the atria. So always the atrioventricular valves, so closes below upwards. So this is atrium, this is ventricle. So always they close like this, and they prevent the blood back flow. So blood will not go back into the atrium, so that ultimately the blood has to divert into the great vessels. It can be arch of aorta or it can be pulmonary trunk. And atrioventricular valves are guarded by the papillary muscles. These are the muscles which are connected to the ventricular myocardial muscles. Semilunar valves, these arch of aorta and pulmonary trunk has got the semilunar valves. These semilunar valves always closes in this direction. Always closes in this direction so that they prevent the blood flow from the blood vessels into the ventricles. They always prevent the blood regurgitation, that is called regurgitation, backflow. Prevent the regurgitation of the blood from the arch of aorta and pulmonary trunk into the ventricles. They always prevent. So now the atrioventricular valves closes in this direction, and pulmonary artery and arch of aorta, semilunar valves, closes in this direction. Atrioventricular valves close in this direction and they close in this direction, so that ultimately they create the functional organization of the pumping system of the heart, because heart always contract and relax. This contraction process is called systole, relaxation process is called diastole. Systole, diastole, contraction, relaxation. And the functional anatomy, when you look at the functional anatomy of the heart, the cardiac muscle are basically divided into the two varieties. One is the contractile muscles, the second one is the conducting muscles. Conducting muscles, contractile muscles. And one must remember, the cardiac muscles are under self-excitatory in nature. The muscle always contract, relax, contracts in relaxation, contract, relax, relax, contract, relax. So that is, the property is known as autorhythmicity, automaticity, autorhythmicity or automaticity. That means the cells, the cardiac cells, always contract, relax on its own without any external factors. The cardiac muscle always contracts on its own without any external factor. Of course, the heart is being innervated by the sympathetic and parasympathetic fibers, but however, the basic intrinsic self-excitatory nature of the heart is coming from heart muscle itself. That is known as automaticity, self-excitation, automaticity. Automatically they undergo excite and contract. So in this picture I would like to show, there are certain actually conducting modified cells. These are the modified cardiac cells, which dedicated as a conducting system. We have SA node, AV node, internodal fibers, the AV bundle, and His bundle, bundle of His, right and left bundle branches, and Purkinje fibers. So this entire system is known as the conducting system of the heart, which are specialized modified cells, which has got self-excitatory nature. What do you mean by self-excitatory? So the excitation means the cells automatically excite and relax, excite, relax. This is known as, this is a kind of electrical activity. The potential change across the cell membranes, alteration of the potential change. For example, this is the cell membrane. So the potentials, the electrolytes, sodium, potassium, chloride, calcium, are existing in different proportions across the cell membrane, inside the cell or outside the cell. So when they are rest, there are certain potentials, you know, arranges proportionately in outside and inside, ECF, extracellular fluid and intracellular fluid of any cell, particularly excitable tissue, excitable cell. Cardiac muscle here are the excitable cells. When they stimulate, when they get excited, the potentials alters. These electrolytes will change their proportions. That means the electrolytes will try to go inside the cell. Some electrolytes come out, try to come out of the cell. So this creates some potential difference across the cell membrane, so that the cells actually undergo the excitation, that is kind of electrical activity, electricity, but this electricity is very, very minimal quantity. So this automaticity or excitation is known as the pacemaker action, pacemaker cells, pacemaker automaticity, self excitation. So there is a coordination in the conduction of the electrical activity, the excitation. And coming to the cardiac muscle physiology, the, as I mentioned, the cardiac cells are excites automatically. So these cardiac cells has got very specialized attachments. These are known as the intercalated discs, and these cells actually connected through the gap junctions. This is the cardiac muscle a view under microscope, and we have the different the cellular organelles. These are the mitochondria, nucleus, and this area is known as the sarcoplasmic reticulum, and these cells usually connected with the gap junctions, and we have Z line, E line, H line. There are different bands, alternative bands, actin, myosin filaments present in the cardiac muscles. Actin, myosin filaments, these are the proteins which facilitates the contraction and relaxation of the muscle fibers. So we have very specialized connecting cell adhesion molecules which connects the cell to cell, and acting as a channels which allows the potentials passes from one cell to the another cell. That is the reason why the entire cardiac muscle works as a single syncytium, single unit. If we stimulate one cell, complete cardiac muscle undergo stimulation. The cardiac cycle. Coming to the cardiac cycle. The cardiac cycle is defined as the contraction and relaxation timing of the heart. The cycle means the event starts from one place and again ends in the same place. That is known as cycle. Cycle word has come from the circus. The circus, the event starts from one place and comes back to the same place. The cardiac cycle means the mechanical electrical pressure changes. Electrical mechanical pressure changes that usually occurs in every beat of the heart. Means in every contraction and relaxation, there are electrical event changes, there are mechanical changes, there are pressure changes. Three types of changes that usually we read in under the cardiac cycle. The contraction and relaxation of the heart beating is known as cardiac cycle. In the cardiac cycle, when our heart rate is 75 beats per minute, the complete contraction and relaxation of the heart takes place within 0.8 seconds. Out of 0.8 seconds, the contractility of the ventricle takes place around 0.3 seconds, and relaxation of the ventricle takes place around 0.5 seconds, together 0.8 seconds. Whereas atrial contraction takes place 0.1 second and atrial relaxation 0.7 second. Total 0.8 second. That means the heart, the cardiac cycle, the contraction relaxation of the heart is divided into the two cycles. One is atrial cycle, the second one is ventricle cycle. Under the atrial cycle, the atria contract and relax, ventricle contract, relax. So contraction phase of the atria is 0.1 second and relaxation phase of the atria 0.7 second, together 0.8 second. When it comes to the ventricle, the contraction phase of the ventricle is 0.3 second and relaxation of the ventricle cycle is 0.5 second. So contraction, systole, relaxation, diastole. So the cardiac cycle, actually contraction, relaxation, contraction, relaxation. So atrial cycle, ventricle cycle, atrial cycle, ventricle cycle. So total the cardiac cycle is 0.8 second. Out of that, atria contracts very short time and relaxes very long time. Whereas ventricle contract up to 0.3 second and ventricle relax up to 0.5 second. So this is the cardiac cycle, contraction relaxation. And the cardiac cycle is a sequence of events as the blood enters into the atria, leaves the ventricle and then starts over. So this is known, this entire process happens with the help of electrical activity, with the help of pressure changes, with the help of mechanical event changes. Synchronizing this intrinsic electrical conducting system, we have electrical conducting system. As I mentioned in earlier slide, we have SA node, AV node conducting system. And influencing the rate, chronotropic, bromotropic effect by the sympathetic and parasympathetic innervations to the heart. As I mentioned, cardiac muscles are having the intrinsic property of automatic excitation or automatic contraction relaxations. But however, this automatic contraction relaxations usually being regulated by our brain. In fact, the brain is the one or the main center which regulates complete our body. But however, the cardiovascular system also one of them. The heart is being innervated, receives the information from the brain via two nerves. One is the sympathetic, second one is the parasympathetic nerve. So these nerves try to regulate or balance the contractility property. The speed of contraction of the heart depends on the body requires, depends on our requirement of our body depends on. You know, for example, when I starting the exercise, when I switch over the exercise, so automatically my heart rate has to increase more and more in order to pump the blood, right? So in this case, the sympathetic nervous system will you know, promotes the increasing the heart rate, increasing the automaticity. And this is cardiac cycle, how it contracts. So initially, let us see the cardiac cycle in you know, videographic point of view. The cardiac cycle phases: systole, period of contraction, as I mentioned, diastole, period of relaxation. Systole, diastole, systole, diastole, systole, diastole. And cardiac cycle is alternating periods of systole and diastolic cycles. Phases of the cardiac cycle: rest, both atria and ventricle in diastole. Blood is filling both atria and ventricle due to low pressure conditions. So while filling, the atria or ventricle will relax. So during relaxation, the pressure in the ventricle or atria goes very minimal, so that blood move into that place, into that cavity. Atrial systole, isovolumic contraction. These are the phases of the cardiac cycle. I just mentioned very simple way: the atrial contraction, atrial relaxation, ventricular contraction, ventricular relaxation. Okay. And the cardiac output means the amount of the blood being pumped by our heart per minute, that is known as the cardiac output. In our body, we have 5 to 6 liters of the blood, but the heart, you know, in you know, every beat, it contract and pumps approximately 70 to 80 ml per beat, one beat. During contraction of the ventricle, it pumps. When you look at the right ventricle or left ventricle, both ventricle pumps simultaneously 70 to 80 ml of the blood into the systemic circulation and pulmonary circulation. The blood which is going into the pulmonary circulation is undergoing the oxygenation. The blood which is going into the systemic circulation is supplying the oxygen to the tissue. So simultaneously, in one contraction, both ventricle pumps approximately 70 to 80 ml of the blood. If you look at the minute pumping capacity, minute pumping per minute, how much blood is pumped by our heart per 1 minute, that is known as cardiac output. So how do we calculate minute pumping capacity? So we have to see how much blood of ventricle is pumping per beat and how many beats are there per minute. For example, if I am pumping 75 ml of the blood per beat, approximately 72 times per minute, my contraction of the heartbeat is around 72 beats. So approximately my cardiac output may be around 5 liters per minute. So the cardiac output is a product of heart rate into stroke volume. So per beat, the ml of the blood being pumped by ventricles, that may be 70 to 80 ml. So that is called stroke volume. One stroke, how much volume being pumped by one ventricle, that is called stroke volume. The heart rate, the stroke volume and heart rates are the product of cardiac output. The minute blood, minute volume being pumped by our heart, that is known as cardiac output. And the BP, when we look at the BP, the blood pressure, the how much pressure being exerted by our heart, how much pressure being exerted by heart per one cardiac cycle. During cardiac cycle, during systole, the maximum pressure we see. During systole of the ventricle, during maximum contraction, we see the maximum pressure recorded in the brachial artery or any other arteries in the body. So conveniently, we record the brachial arterial pressure. So that is called systolic BP, systolic BP. So the maximum amount of blood pressure or pressure generated by the left ventricle is recorded here. So the pressure means the maximum, the BP means the maximum pressure being generated, being produced by ventricular area. So the pressure is coming from ventricle all over the body into the blood vessels. So that is known as systolic BP, that is around 120 millimeters of mercury. Then the minimum pressure during one cardiac cycle being produced by ventricle, that means during the relaxation of the ventricle, how much pressure again recorded here. So that is minimal pressure in one cycle, that is called diastolic BP. Systolic BP means the maximum pressure being recorded by the ventricle during the contraction phase. During one cardiac cycle, we can say in one cardiac cycle, that means relaxation and contraction, relaxation, contraction. This is one cardiac cycle, systole, diastole, systole, diastole, systole, diastole. So in this complete cardiac cycle, how much maximum pressure is being generated by left ventricle, that is recorded from the brachial artery, and how much the minimum pressure is recorded or generated by the left ventricle, that is also recorded here. So that is known as our BP, blood pressure. So 120 by 80 millimeters of mercury. Right. So in this lecture, in summary, I just would like to walk on the what are things being discussed. One is the basic functions of the cardiovascular system, structural organization of the cardiovascular system, excitation of the cardiac muscles, pacemaker cells, and cardiac cycle and events, and cardiac output and factors affecting the cardiac output, and lastly blood pressure. So with this I'm concluding today's lecture. If you have any further doubts, please drop a mail to me. I just mentioned the mail here on the screen. You can drop a mail if you have any further doubts. Thank you for assigning with me.